What do you really know about lymphoma? Probably that it's a common type of cancer. Maybe you know it's a blood cancer, split into two major classes, Hodgkin lymphoma and non-Hodgkin lymphoma. But once you get past that point, there can be a lot of misunderstanding and confusion about the disease. So let's look at five myths involving lymphoma to set the record straight. Myth number one, lymphoma and leukemia are basically the same. Not quite. Think of lymphoma and leukemia as cousins. They're related, but they're two totally different blood cancers. In the most general of descriptions, lymphoma focuses more on your lymph nodes and lymphatic system, while leukemia primarily affects your blood and bone marrow. Symptoms and treatments for each disease are not the same either. Myth number two, there's only one type of non-Hodgkin lymphoma. NHL actually comes in many types that behave and are treated quite differently. For starters, NHL is often divided into two categories, indolent or slow-moving, and aggressive, where the cancer grows quickly. But the cancer is also grouped by whether it started in the B cells or T cells within your immune system. NHL is more common in B cells, which create antibodies to help your body fight off infections, like bacteria and viruses. Myth number three, people who get diagnosed with lymphoma are lucky. The statement pops up regularly, so let's start with this. It's never lucky to get cancer, a life-changing and life-threatening disease. But in the realm of cancers, it's true that lymphoma is very treatable. Nearly 90% of people with Hodgkin lymphoma are alive 5 years after a diagnosis. The number is above 70% for those with NHL. Better yet, those rates continue to climb as treatment programs improve. Myth number four, kids get leukemia, not lymphoma. While it's true that leukemia is the most common cancer in children and teens, that doesn't mean the group is immune to lymphomas. About 8% of cancers affecting young people are lymphoma. Myth number five, lymphoma is an inherited disease. The answer isn't a solid yes, but it's not a solid no either. Having lymphoma in your family's health history does seem to increase your risk of a positive diagnosis. However, your risk level can also rise due to a virus, including HIV and mononucleosis, an immune system weakened by an illness or medical treatment, such as an organ transplant, autoimmune diseases, chronic infections. Various environmental factors also may be a cause, which may help explain why lymphoma is more likely in late adulthood, even though people get it at all ages. Bottom line, lymphoma is a common cancer that's often complicated to understand. Given that there are more than 70 different types, lymphoma causes a range of symptoms that have different treatment options. If you're diagnosed with lymphoma, talk to your healthcare provider to fully understand what to expect.